Hey there, it's Jang again with another new tribe for LEGO's Mixels Series 4. These are the Glowkies. We're going to start with a look at the four-legged Boogly, who kind of looks like he's inspired by the design of a frog. The way that, yeah, that's definitely designed by, or inspired by the design of a frog. He's a funny looking dude. These toenails, if you will, or toes, look like they're glow in the dark, but they're not. Those are actually just light aqua colored cheese slope pieces. He's got the spider leg style antennae there. Nice thick body, you know, really bulky back there, but he's got a lot of expressiveness in his head because he can really turn the head around. It's on a ball joint, so you can really make him look in different directions. You can really open the head way up to look very scary. I like how he's got two rows of teeth in there. And to add a little bit of extra motion to the face, you can turn the eye so he can be looking separately from the direction that you turn the head around. The front legs go up and down just straight, so you can kind of make him look like he's having kind of a walking or moving pose. And the rear legs are on these ball joints, so they can pretty much be kind of rotated around and moved back and forth just a little bit, not so much forward and back, but more out to the side like that. But because of the way these front legs are done, you make him kind of look like he's looking down towards the ground. And I believe you can also, there we go, something like that, make him look like he's sitting down and gazing towards the stars. This one here is Vampos with the big teeth in the front. And he's got some pretty cool wings because you can turn these upwards, you can bring them down, you can also rotate them here. So you can get some very different looks to the wings, even though it's such a simple assembly, really. You kind of bring those in, tuck them in, you know, like that, like a little duckling kind of look. Or you can make him look like he's actually flying. It's just a lot of motion that you can get out of the wings. It's kind of his major feature for posing and playing, I think. The head on this one, it's on a ball joint, but there's not a whole lot you can do with it because you're just so limited by those teeth. You can bring it down, but what are you going to do with that? You can't really rotate the whole body back because of the way that the ball joints for the legs are oriented. There's not much room to move there. You can kind of rotate these out, something like that. Yeah, just not a whole lot of usefulness for the joint at the head, except for turning it side to side. So that's kind of what you want to try to take advantage of for that one, to get some expressiveness out of him. Not really able to turn the head this way very much either, but for him, it's all about the teeth and the wings, I would say. There's a look at the back, if I didn't show that yet. Vampos is also the figure in this tribe that comes with a Nixel this time around, and it's a new design for Series 4. He's got the three small ears, and he also has the ability to move the arms, and the arms can go all the way straight up in the air, both of them, so you can get a little bit of expressiveness out of these and some different posing out of them. This guy's been just dying to say hello. This is Glowbert. Notice the new eyepiece there, the 2x2 round tile with just the little white, little highlight spot there. You can rotate that around depending upon how you connect it. You just kind of change that to make him look like he's kind of looking in a different direction, even though this whole thing is an iris or a pupil. This guy's got the bigger dark blue wings, and you can bring these back like that. He can bring them forward, kind of use them like arms. He can be waving them. He can also rotate them, so you can get a lot of motion out of these. You can rotate it up and down in the front while also bringing it in and out. You can really flap them. You can change the shape depending upon which part you want to be facing forward and which direction you want the flapping to go. That's pretty cool. It's got kind of ears, I guess, cat style ears up on the top. The entire head is able to open and close, so that's pretty cool. And notice he's got these canines that are way out to the sides, so he's got actually a very wide mouth, or at least the upper jaw is very wide. And once again, pretty standard stuff for The legs these days with Mixels, with just the ball joint there, let you rotate these in and out, also splay them outwards and bring them back in. But yeah, you get a good amount of variability to the different types of poses you can get out of this figure thanks to its clever use of joints. Doesn't look all that great from behind though. Last thing I can try to show you on all of these is how they glow in the dark. It's just the eyes on each. They don't really glow brightly unless you're really at night. You know, you want to be in a completely dark room, really get those charged up a lot, and then you'll be able to see the glow, but it does kind of fade away pretty quickly. That's it for the Series 4 Glowkies. Be sure to post up a comment with your choice for your favorite out of these three. For me, my favorite is Glowbird, but I do like the whole series. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more videos to come, as well as the combination Max models. Talk to you soon.